Welcome to ArtMind. Today we are learning the count tool in Photoshop. The count tool is located under the eyedropper tool and its shortcut is I. Now many of the times a Photoshop project is managed by a team of members. Suppose you are the team head and you want the first three balls to be changed to yellow. Also imagine that this is a very complicated image and it's really hard to convey the message for the changes to be made over phone or maybe email. So what you can do is take the count tool inside these balls and start numbering them. Once you have done that, you can send the Photoshop file to the concerned person and call and ask him to change the color of the balls which you have numbered 1, 2 and 3. You can change the color of the counters if you like. You can change the size of the dots. Or even the numbers. You can move the counters if you want, just click on the dot and drag it. Now the counters automatically form a group which you can rename over here. I'm gonna name it first set. So these three counters belong to a group called first set. Now as a team head, you might think that these bottom three balls should be green. What you can do is create a new group by clicking this icon. I'm gonna name this group second set. I want to change the color of this group just to differentiate them. Then I'm gonna go ahead and drop the numbers on each of these three circles. You can notice that since this is a new group, it has started counting from 1 and not from 4. But now you think that this ball from the top row should also be yellow. You can go ahead and select the first set over here. Then when you click on the circle, it's gonna continue the numbering of the first set, which is 4. Likewise, you can also ask for this ball to be changed to green. I'm gonna go ahead and select the second set. Then I'm gonna just continue the numbering over here. Suppose you want to hide the numbers of the top row. Since they belong to the first set, I'm gonna select the first set. Then I'm gonna click on this icon to hide them. Click again to bring them back. We can do the same for the second set. Alternatively, you can also delete the entire set. Suppose I want to delete the second set, so I'm gonna go ahead and select the second set and hit the trash icon over here. So you're not gonna see the second set over here anymore. I'm just gonna quickly undo that. Now with the clear option, the group stays, only the counters get deleted. So if I want to delete just the counters for the second group or the second set, I'll make sure that the second set is selected and then I'll hit clear. You can see that the second group or the second set is still there, although its counters are all deleted. So now you can add fresh counters for the pre-existing group. And it's worth mentioning over here at the end of this tutorial that the note tool goes hand in hand with the count tool. For example, since we wanted the circles of the upper row to be turned to yellow, let me just select the first set. Then I'm gonna grab the note tool from here under the same stack. Then I'm gonna click somewhere over here near the top row. Maybe change its color for color coordination. Then I'm gonna type in the instructions for these balls. I've already made an entirely separate tutorial on note tool alone. I'll leave the link in the description and highly recommend you check that out. This is all I have for the count tool in Photoshop. Make sure to check the other videos. I'll see you next time. Bye.